Okay, we're gonna go over really quick how to calculate the resistor that you need to put in series with an LED so you don't blow it up. The reason we need this is because once you pass the forward voltage of an LED, a slight increase in the voltage makes a huge increase in the current, and we don't wanna blow things up. So we put a resistor in series with it that keeps it under control and it makes it have a little bit more of a linear relationship between the voltage and the current. Though it's not exact, it's better. So I have 6 steps for choosing the resistor, but 2 of them are sanity checks and the other 4 are really simple. So definitely don't stress about it. So the first thing, you need to find out the forward voltage. So that's either from the data sheet, a generic source like our color and forward voltage table on our website, or from simple experimentation. I bought this from SparkFun, and I don't know if they still do this because I did it a couple of years ago, but they have some of the basic data you need in the package itself. It's pretty cool. So I can see straight from here that the voltage drop of this LED is 2.2 volts. That makes it easier than going and looking in the data sheet, but if you don't know, it's worth it. So that is the first thing, find out what the forward voltage drop of your LED is. Now the second thing is to find out what the max current is. This should also be from the data sheet, and you can almost always go past the max current and still have it work, but you'll be shortening its life. So again, looking on here, this says Imax is 20 milliamps, which is very, very, very typical for this size of LED. I'm actually not sure if I've ever seen one that's different than 20 milliamps on these, but if you get a bigger LED or smaller LED, you want to check that data sheet to make sure that you don't blow this. So the third thing is actually a continuation of step 2, and that is we know that this can have 20 milliamps before it starts to damage it, but how much do I actually want? Do I need it to be that bright? Can I use less current? So step 3 is find out how much current you actually want. And that could be something where you just have to do a little bit of trial and error and see how much current is needed to give it the brightness that you want. And that's all you have to do. So once you know what the forward voltage drop is and you know how bright you want it to be, how much current you need to have go through it, making sure that you don't go over the maximum current, you do step 4, which is figuring out what the resistance will require to hit that current. So you can use Ohm's law and just math it, which is voltage source minus the forward voltage at the desired current and then voltage over current. So in that case, we have the voltage source. We're just gonna assume 5 volts because that's very common and just keeps the math simple. The voltage drop on this is 2.2 volts. So 5 minus 2.2 gives you 2.8. And then you just divide that by the 20 milliamps. So we actually have an app, something on our site where you can first see this all laid out visually, gives you the equation and you can type it in. So voltage source, 5 volts. The voltage drop of the LED is 2.2 volts. And then the current of the LED is going to be 20 milliamps. So doing that, and that way I don't have to do the math in my head, gives us 140 ohms. So that is basically how you figure that out. And that's step 4. Now the next 2 steps are just sanity checks. And number 5 is making sure the resistor that you physically actually are using has a high enough power rating. So I'm gonna use a 1/4 watt resistor with this. And looking at my calculations here, it's showing that I'm only gonna be consuming about 44 milliwatts. So I can handle 250 milliwatts. This says I'm only gonna be consuming 44 milliwatts. I'm good to go. And then number 6, the other sanity check is just making sure that everything makes sense. So if you have a 12 volt battery source and a 3 volt LED, why not put 3 or 4 of them in series, 3 or 4 LEDs in series, instead of all of them in parallel with huge power wasting resistors for the rest of the voltage? If your max current is 1 amp, but you're only driving it to 1 milliamp, why don't you use a smaller, cheaper LED? If this is just a project you're doing for the fun of it, then efficiency and saving a couple pennies isn't such a big deal. Just go and have some fun. But if you are planning on something that's a little bit more logical, a little bit more sensical, take that time to think, how much power am I burning here? Is this oversized? Is this undersized? And then go from there. So with that, I actually want to do this really quick. Now, we calculated at 140 ohms, but in reality, unless you're doing high precision resistors, they're at a different rate. So you don't get 100, 102, 104, 105. You get the 100, 142, 150, 100, like the more random numbers. So I'll probably only be able to find a 150 ohm resistor to go with this, but that's okay. If you can't get the exact resistance, if you're already pushing the limit, you want to go up a little bit in resistance. So 150 ohms will be perfect for this. So I'm just going to grab my power source here and turn it on. Yep. So it's going to be 5 volts because again, that's fairly common with USB. I'm going to hook this up to the anode. I'm going to spread that out. And then I'm going to hook up to the resistor and hook up to the cathode, and we're gonna see what happens. All right, we're getting a bright, shiny green LED. And not only that, but just as you can see here, I've got 5 volts and we're at 19 milliamps, which is about exactly what we expected with a 150 ohm resistor. So again, we're gonna be burning much less than this 1/4 watt resistor can handle. And I think we'll be good to go. So that is what happens in action. So again, all those steps really quick. First, find the forward voltage. Second, find the max current. Third, figure out what current you want as long as it doesn't go over that max current. Fourth, use Ohm's law to find out what resistance you need. Fifth, make sure that your resistor is rated for the power dissipation that you're actually going to be putting it through. And then sixth and final is just make sure that your whole circuit makes sense, that you're not doing something crazy inefficient or really expensive that just doesn't need to happen. And that's it. It's really straightforward. Don't even need all of those steps. If you just get rid of those sanity checks, you'll be fine. If you like this video, give us a like, subscribe, leave something in the comments, and we'll see you next time.